people, if what you have is that for optics, your choices are between these two dudes right here. That's all the choices that you're gonna need. Because I'm telling you, I've done the work for you. And by the end of this video, you're gonna have this put to use. Vortex has been on an absolute winning streak with the value proposition. I mean, just, it's immense. I am in no way compensated by Vortex, the company. I don't know them at all. But I do know value. And I do know optics. And I've been using the optics from Vortex with absolute glee. It started with the Vanquish, that little itty-bitty subcompact unit that fits in your pocket and you can take it anywhere, and I have. It was my piece that I took with me for vacation in North Carolina at the Biltmore. You saw that video. If you didn't, go through the videos and you'll find it easily. Then we came to this thing right here. The Copperhead unit that they came out with. In 10x42, roof prism design. This is the box that it came in. Basic box, 10x42. I don't think they offer an 8x42 unit. And frankly, I think this is a limited production. Let's read the specs together. So you got the Vortex Copperhead HD. Magnification is 10x42. Field of view, 334 feet. Angular, 6.4 degrees. People, in 10x, that field of view is spectacular. It whoops. Literally whoops. My Neos Athlon 10x42 unit, which was my go-to entry unit into the world of roof prism binoculars several years back. Athlon still makes great binoculars, but these guys are just on a different playing field now, and they're putting out products like you wouldn't believe. Closed focus, 15.3 feet, eye relief, 17 millimeters. Why is that important? 17 millimeter eye relief for people that wear glasses like me. I need an eye relief above 15 millimeters for sure in order to get full field of view and general comfort in the use of binoculars. 17 millimeters, we're good to go. Weight, 22.9 ounces. Not much difference in weight, maybe an ounce greater for the Athlons, but oh my goodness, that field of view and the immersion that you get from it with 10x as opposed to the great field of views that you can get with 42 millimeter objective lens with 8x, with 10x, you're getting the normal field of view that one would get for an 8x unit in 42 millimeter objective lens size. It's incredible. But let's go on to what you get in the box. You get this thing. My Athlons did not come with this. This is great. This is a chest harness. You would pay normally between $30 to $50 for a good quality chest harness. It comes free with this Vortex Copperhead unit. Free. And this Vortex Copperhead unit right now is $104 on Amazon. It's incredible. Silent, no Velcro. Very nicely padded. The binocular unit fits into the harness very cleanly, very nicely. It attaches to one's chest by use of the belt system that comes in the box. I just wanted to show you the extra value that you get with these Vortexes. Putting that aside, let's talk about this unit. The strap, let's start there. Classic neoprene strap, Vortex emblem. Doesn't have the click lock system, which some higher end units are using nowadays by click lock. You're talking about the attachment of the strap to the body of the binoculars in an easy fashion. Just clicks in. My Steiner Night Hunters have the click lock system. They are spectacular. But my Steiner Night Hunters, you're talking about $1,100, $1,200. One Benjamin is what you're going to spend on this. Incredible value. I went out in the field today. One of these objective lens covers, which do attach, okay? I will give Vortex that. The lens cover, objective lens covers attach, fall off very nicely when you're ready to use the unit, right? Problem is that they made this band right here that attaches it to the body of the unit a little too loose. And that happens. So the plan for this is going to be to use a little bit of epoxy underneath this little band and putting it back on the body of this unit so that it stays there. This dropped when I was doing the test in nature today. This dropped right off and I thought I lost it forever. I picked it back up when I was headed back to the car, which is a good thing. In that regard, the Athlons, these things don't come off. They've made this band a little wider right here, and they've made it so that it's tight. This is difficult to get off the body. Good thinking and good design by Athlon on the cover. But the cover is just one part of the equation, right? Let's add to the body itself. Armor coated. You can see me putting some indents with my fingernails into the unit. Pops right back up. Very nice armor coating all over the unit itself. Very, very nice armor coating. Protects the unit, keeps your hands from slipping on it if they're wet in the snow or rain, and gives some protection to the unit itself. All good there. In that regard, the Athlon, same thing. You've got nice armoring, You can see my fingernail digging deeply and then returning to shape. The color on these Neoses I love. The stippling job on these Neoses I love. Just look at that color with the little accents of the orange. Fabulous, fabulous. And they did a magnificent job with the stippling and the overall design of these Neoses. The Vortex, more basic, okay? On the side over here, this is not stippling per se. It's more of a very nice hexagonal design work, which gives you a lot of traction. A lot of traction here. Once you have a nice purchase of this unit in your hand, you feel comfortable, confident. You're not going to drop it, even if you're using it with one hand. Focus wheel. Armor coated, as you can see, soft armor coating, no play. Each little minute movement of this wheel is changing the focus of the unit. Fabulous engineering. Take that little top off and you've got your tripod attachment right there. Is it as pretty? No. More basic, but gets the job done. And this is the roof prism entry point into the world of Vortex. And they've done a great job. Great job. 42 millimeter objective lens. That's your size of objective lens from one point to the other of the lens itself. Multi-coated very nicely. On the eye cover, you've got nice, soft rubber, which I have attached with a little key ring because that's how I like to attach my eye covers. I want the eye cover to fall and stay out of my way while I'm using the unit. Diopter setting. Very nice. Just the right amount of pressure required so that you don't have it wiggling while you're using the unit. And unlike the Vortex, my Leopolds came, and if you watch that video, my Leopold Rogue unit came with a problem with the sitting of the eye cups properly. No problem here with this Vortex. Eye cups, you've got 1, 2 detents. So flat right now. Detent number 1, detent number 2. Detent number 1, detent number 2. In that regard, you've got a small distinction with the Athlons. With the Athlons, let's talk about the eye covers on the Athlons. Very nice. Again, soft rubber, not the hard plastic that comes on some lesser units. This one, as you can see, does not have the key ring, and therefore it stays right in that position and completely in my way, so that when I'm using this unit, that eye cover is just flip-flopping on the side of my hand. Don't like that. I'm going to be changing to the use of the ring, key ring that I showed you on the other unit. As far as eye cup here, one, it's actually three. So that's your base. One, two, three. Three detents on this one. Audible sounds on the detents, very nice quality. Between 0.2 and 0.3, not much of a rise, but nice to have. Gives you a little bit more custom feel to these Athlon Neoses. Remember the field of view on the Vortexes? On the Neoses, field of view is written on the wheel, focus wheel, 309 feet. You remember what it was for the Vortex Copperhead? 334 feet. The immersion that you get into the sight picture with these, really nice. I use this unit in the park today. Loved it. Absolutely loved it. The field of view, the clarity of it. Is it the most clear from edge to edge? No. This is their entry model. It's $100. Don't expect edge to edge clarity that you would get with a Steiner Night Hunter. You're not going to get it at this price point. And you understand that going in. But is it any less pleasurable to use this unit? Absolutely not. I love this Copperhead unit. The value proposition from Vortex with making this unit for us is tremendous. Tremendous. Even though I think I like the color combination of these Athlons, in what you are going to be using binoculars for in nature, to enjoy your scenery and feel like you're a part of it, these right here. And the value proposition that Vortex has given us with putting into the box the extras, it's just incredible.